And in the spirit of equity and peaceful coexistence in Kwara State, the people of Kwara North Senatorial District have appealed to both critical stakeholders and politicians in the other two senatorial districts of Central and South to concede the governorship position to Kwara North come 2027. At 15 of the All Progressive Congress in the state, Babakolo Jia made the plea while speaking at the 41st Media Parliament of Nigeria Union of Journalists, Kwara State Council in Ilorun, the Kwara State capital, with the theme Religion, Politics, and Kwara 2027 Guba Race.
For the sake of understanding ourselves, since this democratic setting, I want to beg other senatorial areas, South and Central, that they should please concede 2027 governorial election to us. For the sake of that coexistence that has been existing for us. Now let me tell you one something about Kwara North. We are very, very united people.
Kwara North has been talking, but they are not walking the talk. I said they must do something that will be feasible to the blind, audible to the deaf, and sensitive to at least a least intelligent Kwara, that they are ready. They are not showing that commitment enough. Freedom has never been voluntarily given in the entire world by the oppressor to the oppressed. The oppressed must fight for it. And I said, if they are not ready, the others only in this state, we are equally ready to take the mantle.
He, however, challenged religious leaders from both Islam and the Christian faith not to leave politics in the hands of secular politicians alone. While the state chairman of Nigerian Union of Journalists, Kwara State Council, Abdul Latif Lare, urged citizens to disregard sentiments while making electoral decisions to recruit credible leaders.
Our pastors, our imams, should not leave politics in the hands of the secular people. We should also come to join politics because they are the custodians of our norms. They are the custodians of what God says.
Even though another transition period in our political calendar is some miles away, the onus is on us as media to make sure that citizens are properly guided and cognizant of the set of leaders they will recruit to administer them when the time comes.